With the Cycle Master now finished and off the bench, and before the next bike goes up to be finished, I took a bit of time to assess some parts that I got off of eBay at the right price. It's a James Superlux Autocycle, around 1950s, probably around 54 or 55. It came as a basket case, which means usually that it's just a pile of bits in a box. Bought sight unseen off of eBay, and a good friend of mine collected them for me and kept them for me until I had a chance to get them shipped back to Ireland. Anyway, you can see here that I'm putting the bits together loosely. I've got the back wheel in place, again loosely, and I also picked up an engine cheap a couple of weeks later, a Villiers 2F. So I've been very lucky with the bits so far. Anyway, putting the engine in here, just again put it into place, see if it fits, make sure everything's okay, it's the correct engine for this model, and so far so good. In the pile of bits was also the mud guards, the rack, an old saddle, well past its sell-by date, the front forks, the wheel, front mudguard, and something that usually goes missing, a toolbox. There was also a chain guard and an old exhaust that definitely didn't come from this particular model. So keep putting the bits together, make sure all the holes line up and they're not sort of painted the right colour but come off a totally different bike. And just making sure as you're going along that there's no broken studs or torn threads or bits of bolts stuck in holes, that sort of thing. And general conditions of the petrol tank, what's it like inside? Although being a two-stroke with petrol oil mix, they usually are quite nice inside. Keeping an eye out for broken tabs and keeping a list of stuff that's missing. Obviously all the bright work on this particular bike is missing. There was no pedal cranks, no handlebars, levers. And this is what you're looking out for, what bits you need to collect until you get to a point where it's worth putting together. The front fork links are definitely missing. I've got a spring for the front end. It seems a bit short, but luckily enough I picked another one up off eBay, and it's with my mate in England waiting to come over. So far the assembly is going well. Everything seems to be fitting into place as if it did come off the original bike. So we just keep tipping away and see exactly what we've got. This particular bike is basically the last generation of autocycles. It wasn't long after this that people started riding the mopeds, NSU Quickly, Pooch Maxi, or M50 before the Maxi, but you know what I mean. You can tell already that certain cost cutting measures had been taken, shall we say. The rims were painted, very little bright work on the bikes, and just anything they could possibly do to reduce the cost, they did. You have to remember these were in direct competition with a very similarly priced Bantam, or the other type of small motorbikes. James Cadet, that type of vehicle. So they were on a hiding to nothing by this stage. They were underpowered, brakes weren't really good enough, and people were just expecting better standards. But thankfully people are getting interested in them again. There are some very, very nice design features and styling touches that came with these particular autocycles that was lost. on the mass-produced vehicles that followed. So I'm glad it's people are getting an interest in them. There's not many of them left. They were thrown in hedges just because they were worthless at the time. And the ones that survived were thrashed within an inch of their life. So it's nice to see them getting put back together again. Another benefit of this dry assembly before you actually start work on them or painting them or anything like that is just to figure out how they go together. Sometimes you can put bits on in the wrong order, or they just won't go together the normal way. As you can see here, the forks, you can't put them on first because the mudguard won't fit. You have to put the mudguard over the wheel and then the wheel and the mudguard up into the forks. This dry build just puts you on the path later on of certain things that have to be done in a certain order. There we are, get there in the end. And then with all the bits in place, you sit down and you make a list of all the bits that aren't in place. All the dodgy bits that you found, bits that were missing. In this case, for instance, front brake shoes are missing, even though the back plate's there and the lever's there. The saddle tube is still in place. Someone's cut it off flush with the top. That's going to be a right sod to get out. And then all the bright work. It'll need pedal cranks, chain wheel, chain, both chains. It needs a chain guard for the pedal side, handlebars, list goes on. And eventually I'm hoping it'll look something like this. Anyway, that's it for now. Thanks for watching.